Hello students, welcome to Royal Palace Pew College Jamkhandi online classes. My name is Sanjay sir and I'll be teaching you biology. Today we will be studying about a next topic of the chapter The Living World, and the topic name is taxonomical categories. As I mentioned in my previous video, that was binomial nomenclature, that the entire organisms present on this earth, it's quite difficult for them to remember without any proper name, without the basic morphological and anatomical characteristics, and without the classification. Likewise, keeping that thing in the mind, majority of the scientists decided to organize the organisms in a specific order. Today, this is the topic called as taxonomical category, which is nothing but categorizing the organisms, classifying the organisms depending upon their basic characteristics. Here, the organisms are divided into different ranks, different groups, different classes or classifications, or in general, they are divided into taxon or taxa. So there are totally 7 different taxonomical categories. Namely, it starts from kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. So if I start explaining from kingdom to species, it will be called as a descending order. And if I start explaining from species to kingdom, it is called as an ascending order. Keeping in mind that any organism in this entire planet Earth, it is or it should be completely divided among these 7 categories. So almost all the organisms are divided into these taxonomical categories. So today's topic is understanding these categories. So dear students, let us start by taking the firstest example called as the species. In the hierarchy of taxonomical category, the bottomest part or the lowest part or the basic part will be species. Species will have only one type of organism, and it is called as the basic unit of taxonomy. Species can be defined as closely relating organisms, closely morphological characteristics having organisms, closely anatomical characteristics having organisms, which can interbreed among themselves to produce the fertile offsprings, is called as species. So in case of a species, we find very lowest number of organisms and highest number of characteristics. As I move from species to kingdom, the number of common characteristics decreases and the number of population increases. As I mentioned earlier, that the species contain very less or least number of organisms which should be similar to one another. But according to the calculation, according to explanation of binomial nomenclature, the species should have to have a scientific name. If I have to give an example, according to NCERT, I'll be taking 3 examples here, such as 1. Mangifera indica for mango. Some teachers explain this one as Mangifera indica also. I pronounce this one as Mangifera. You go ahead with your own pronunciations. Example number 2, Solanum tuberosum for potato. Example number 3, Panthera leo for lion. So I am taking 3 examples here, such as the mango, second one as the potato, third one as the lion. All these 3 different names contain 2 words in them. Please refer my topic called as binomial nomenclature, why the organisms having 2 names. But in short, let me tell you, each and every organism should have to have 2 words in their names. The first name should be the genus or the genera name, and the second name should be the species name or specific epithet. Likewise, here also, if I have to take an example of mango, that is Mangifera indica, out of this one, the first word Mangifera is called as genus or genera name, and indica represents the species name. If I go with respect to Solanum tuberosum, where in which Solanum gives you the genus name and the tuberosum gives you the species name. The same thing, if I go to the third category of lion, that is Panthera leo, the Panthera represents the genus name and the leo represents the species name or the specific epithet. It is a common understanding that similarly looking organisms with light differences or small differences will also be considered as a species. But since there are differences in their characteristics, we should mention them as different species itself. It can be understandable that approximately highest number of characters having organisms might be a little different, which indicates that species might be different, but sometimes a genus will include these different species in them. What am I trying to say? I'm trying to say that a genus may contain one species or more than one species also. Sometimes it may contain two species, three species, etc., and so on. If you take an example of Panthera as a genus, it will not contain only Panthera leo as a basic species. It might even contain some other species also, such as Panthera tigris. If I have to take another example of the genus called as the Solanum, it will also have another species called as Solanum nigrum and Solanum melangina. We can even go for our own example, that is Homo sapiens. The word Homo sapiens indicates that the Homo is called as the genus or genera name, and the sapiens indicates the specific epithet. Our biological name is Homo sapiens, wherein which the sapiens indicates the specific epithet. Please do remember these things, students. The next taxonomical category is genus. It is present above the species. It contains more number of organisms than species. It contains less number of common characters than species. But in a genus, the number of characters of those particular species might increase. That's why the similar or more appropriate characters having species are included in the category called as genus. Genus and species have got same kind of explanation. If I have to define genera or genus, I can say that it is nothing but group of species or group of resembling species or an aggregate of related species. If you take an example that potato belongs to different species and brinjal also belongs to different species, but because of some basic general characteristics, potato and brinjal come under one genus, and that is Solanum. I can go for another example connecting to the animals also. Let us go with respect to the Panthera genus. The lion's biological name is called as Panthera leo. Leopard's biological name is Panthera pardus. Likewise, the third one, that is the tiger's biological name is Panthera tigris. These three organisms having different specific epithets but have got a common genus name, that is Panthera. So it is clearly indicating that a genus might contain one or more than one species in it. That's why the name genus is called as the group of related species. I even have to mention another example which is given in NCERT, that is genus Felis. I mentioned there are two types of genus here, one as the Panthera and another one as Felis. The Felis contains different species of cats. Okay, students, I hope you are understanding these terminologies, let us go to the third topic, that is family. Family is the third point which comes after the genus in the taxonomical category. Now, as I mentioned earlier, family is nothing but a group of related genus or genera. Family contains more number of organisms as comparing to genus, and the family contains less number of common characters as comparing to genus. As I explained earlier, that if you go from species to kingdom, the number of organisms increases and the number of common characters decreases. Families are characterized by both the contents of vegetative characteristics and even the reproductive characteristics in case of plants. Among plants, if we take an example of different genus such as Solanum, Petunia and Datura, these are three different genuses. But because of these genuses having same kind of or similar kind of general characteristics, these are placed in one family called as Solanaceae. Among the animals, if I have to consider, genus Panthera comprising lion, leopard and tiger is put along with the genus Felis, which contains different cats in it. And the Panthera genus and Felis genus both are included in one family called as the Felidae. Try to understand here, students, this might be one of the important section of NEET, that as far as the plants are concerned, the plants have got a suffix called as ACA in case of family as a taxonomic category. And at the same time, in case of animals, the animals have got the suffix DAE in case of family as a taxonomic category. The next topic or the taxonomic category is order. As I mentioned once again, I'm repeating again and again in each and every categories, that order is nothing but group of similar families, and it contains higher number of organisms as comparing to family and lower number of common characteristics as comparing to family. So, as I mentioned, that the order is nothing but group of similar characteristics having families. We can say, we can give an example as some plant families such as Solanaceae, Convolvulaceae, having different genus and in turn having different species, are converted into families, of course, and these families are kept in an order called as polymoniales. And at the same time, in my previous category of a family, as I mentioned, that the Felidae and Canidae families are added into an order called as Carnivora. So it is a general arrangement of organisms here. Different organisms having different characteristics are placed into different categories of taxonomic section or hierarchy. In case of plants, it is ending with ales, A-L-E-S as the suffix, but in case of animals, we do not have that kind of a suffix used. The next category is class. Class can be defined as a group of similar orders. It comes after the order, of course, and it contains higher number of organisms as comparing to the order and lower number of common characteristics as comparing to the order. Once again, the same kind of repetition, that if you move from species to kingdom, the number of organisms increase and the number of common characteristics decrease. In case of animals, there are different classes actually. We can study these things in your future videos or future chapters such as Animal Kingdom, wherein which I'll be explaining you some of the classes such as Amphibia, Reptilia, Mammalia, Aves, Pisces. And in these classes, we can say and we can see that different organisms are present with different orders, families, genus, and species in them. Likewise, there is a class called as Mammalia, and this Mammalia contains different orders in it, such as order Primata, comprising monkey, gorilla, gibbon. All these are different organisms which ordered into the class called as Mammalia. And along with this particular order called as Primata, it even includes another order called as Carnivora. And the Carnivora includes some examples such as the tiger, cat, and dog. If we go further into understanding the class Mammalia, it even has got some more deeper orders also. As I explained in my regular classes or videos, that I'll be going only with respect to NCERT syllabus. Okay, students, we'll go to the next category called as Phylum. Phylum is another category which comes after the class. This is nothing but group of similar characteristics having or similar classes in it. This particular category has got higher number of organisms as comparing to class and lower number of common characteristics as comparing to class. Same repetition, that if you move from species to kingdom, the number of organisms increase and the number of common characteristics decrease. Phylum is not at all a simple word actually. If you have to study phylum, this phylum includes so many deeper points, deeper explanations, deeper characteristics, deeper anatomical and the morphological understandings, etc., etc. Phylum can be divided onto the basis of the presence of notochord, the presence of the ventral hollow section, the presence of vertebrate, and the organisms in case of animals are divided into vertebrates and non-vertebrates, chordates and non-chordates, etc., etc. There are so many explanations. We cannot say that there is only one kind of explanation to explain about the phylum, because phylum is not a small topic. It includes a lot of different organisms in it. So depending upon the different sections of the species, they are divided into different phylums. Please be stay with me in my future classes. I'll be explaining you about different phylums connecting to animals and classes such as the fishes, amphibians, reptiles, mammals, aves. All these come under into one of the phylum. And if I have to mention the group of classes in case of animals, I would say that the phylum is a proper word. And if I have to tell you about the group of similar classes in case of plants, I would have to refer another word called as division. Students, I'm going very briefly here. I'm not going much deep into all these sections because these are all for our understanding purposes with respect to our neat and theoretical explanations. Dear students, we have reached the last category of taxonomical categories called as kingdom. The entire world's living organisms are divided into two sections, such as the kingdom Animalia and kingdom Plantae. Kingdom Animalia contains all the animals in it, and kingdom Plantae contains all the plants in it. Sir, what about some other organisms? Those organisms which are not at all coming under the characteristics of plants and animals? Well, all these animals also, will all these organisms also are added into animals or plants, sir? No. There are different kingdoms, and right now we have, with our explanations, we have five kingdoms, and the explanation of those kingdoms will be coming afterwards. But kingdom is the finest, lastest, toppest category which includes all the different phylums in it. So if you go with respect to plants and animals, the kingdom contains highest number of organisms and the kingdom contains lowest number of common characteristics. Kingdom is the topmost category, which explains us in which particular section that we have to look into. For a simple explanation, if there is a cow, then we'll directly think about this one as the animal kingdom. If I have to think about a potato, then we directly have to enter into the kingdom plantae as our basic explanation or classification purposes. So, I hope you are getting all these points with respect to our NCERT explanations. These are called as the taxonomic categories because depending upon the different characteristics of the organisms, these categories are divided. So each and every organism on this earth should have to undergo these seven different categories. And these categories are arranged in an ascending and descending order. That's why it is called as the taxonomical category. Basically, it was explained by one of the scientists called as Carolus Linnaeus. That's why it is also called as Linnaean hierarchy also.